Good morning, New Delhi. Good morning. It's so great to be back here. A warm welcome to our media colleagues, and of course, a warm welcome to the Mi fans on the live stream on Mi Community. It's a bit chilly here in Delhi today. We're going to try to get you as warm as possible. This is our first launch event in India in 2017, and boy, we have a sweet product to talk to you about. You guys ready? A new Note Rises. This is our Batman-style black-on-black visual for the past week. This is our black stage. As you can see, black is our theme for today, and you'll soon find out why. Now, before I start, I want to welcome a very special group that's here today, our Mi Explorers. This is a group of fearless, bug-chasing, data-driven pioneers. They were the first ones to get their hands on this new product and really helped us test, debug, and optimize. And they look really cool and gangster on here, don't they? And guess what? They're obviously here today with us, and of course, sitting on the front row. Mi Explorers, please rise. Thank you guys for being here. We really, really appreciate your help. And we couldn't do this without you. Thank you once again. Okay, so our story today starts with this guy, Redmi Note 3, our best-selling Mi phone to date. 91 Mobiles called it Phone of the Year in 2016, and not only that, but also it was the highest shipped smartphone in India's online smartphone history, according to IDC. Thank you. We sold 3.6 million Redmi Note 3 in 2016. 3.6 million. Redmi Note 3 was a game-changing product in every way. Design, performance, battery life, hand feel. And we gave it this slogan, rise to power. And now, power has a new look. Redmi Note 4 is here. You know, I've been rocking it for the past 4 months or so as my daily driver. So it's a breeze for me personally to explain why it's my favorite Mi phone ever and why it's my favorite smartphone today. No exaggeration. In many ways, it defines what a reliable, consistent daily driver should be. And I'm going to tell you why. Let's start with design. You know, smartphone design is about two things, looks and hand feel, as Jay likes to say. Let's dive in. Here's our first glimpse of Redmi Note 4, a premium metal body. It's just over 8 millimeters in thickness, but it looks and definitely feels thinner than that. And that's because of the tapered edges, which in practice, shave off about 3.5 millimeters of the thickness of the device. So it actually feels more like 5 millimeters when you're holding it in your hand. Redmi Note 4 is our first Redmi product to use 2.5D curved glass on the front. It's a big deal. It's a decidedly much more elegant look, and it makes an edge swipe feel kind of buttery. It's beautiful industrial design, and it's a spectacular hand feel, an incredible hand feel upgrade from Redmi Note 3. Another big upgrade are the separation lines that you see here. It helps with the antenna functionality. We've replaced this seam that you see here on Redmi Note 3 with a very classy anodized aluminum line in Redmi Note 4. It looks really premium. And let's take a look at the bottom. Big change here. The back speaker grille on Redmi Note 3 is gone. It's a much cleaner look, and no need for this little ridge over here anymore. Many of you were not supremely happy with the sound dispersion on Redmi Note 3, especially when it's sitting on a soft surface like a couch. Well, Redmi Note 4 completely eliminates that concern. The bottom-facing speaker grille is as functional as it is elegant. So we're definitely listening, of course. And speaking of symmetry, which is, of course, what we're going for with the new speaker grille, as much as I love Redmi Note 3, I cringe a little bit when I look closely. We've got an off-center audio jack and IR port. We've got an off-center USB charger port and an off-center camera and proc sensor on the front here. Call it OCD on my part, but there's definitely some room for improvement here. Whoa, Denzel Washington. Well, everyone knows Denzel Washington, but most people don't know that he is scientifically considered one of the most symmetrical faces in Hollywood. It's true. Science has proven that people that have more symmetrical faces are considered substantially more good-looking than people with not-so-symmetrical faces. Let's skip that. Redmi Note 4 is beautiful down to that science. It's perfectly symmetrical. USB port, speaker grille, fingerprint sensor, two-tone flash, camera, all perfectly stacked, perfectly centered. It's symmetrically beautiful. And on the white face, just like in Mi Max, you remind yourself of Baymax. That's Baymax saying hello. Hello, Baymax. The white face on Redmi Note 4 is exclusively available on the gold version. It's a much more refined shade of gold, more champagne-like, with beautiful antenna lines in pale gold here, matching the color of the body, and matching the rims around the camera and the fingerprint sensor. Here's a look at front and back on the gold version. Take as many pictures as you like. It's a very classy pairing of white on the front and this classy muted gold on the back. Here's another close-up. You can see the 2.5D glass very closely over here. It's a signature of elegance. It looks very good. Redmi Note 4 also comes in dark gray, paired with the face in black, and the beveled edge here gives a distinct flagship look on the dark gray especially. Very, very solid looking. Now, I mentioned we had a good reason for this Batman-style black-on-black visual in our stage theme. Well, that's because we're introducing a new look with Redmi Note 4. Check out the product video. Yes, for the first time ever, we're launching Redmi Note 4 in a super sleek matte black finish. And the lines here, the separation lines, are even more gorgeous. We're using a silvery black mirror finish that really blends nicely with the black matte body. Black coated aluminum body. It looks fantastic. It's an entire new look, in fact, in the Redmi portfolio. Here you can see a close-up of the beveled edges. The black front, look how perfectly black the display is, and really how it blends in. It perfectly disappears into the front of the device when the display is off. And when it comes to life, it looks great. So this is Redmi Note 4 in black. This version will be available soon after the launch. And this is not a computer rendering. This particular photo is a real-life shot taken in our Bangalore office. It's just gorgeous. I absolutely love this photo. Take as many shots as you want. And here's the whole Redmi Note 4 family in gold, dark gray, and black. Do you guys want to see it?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, here we are. Ladies and gentlemen, Redmi Note 4. I have one more shot for you guys, too, in a second. Okay. Let's go to the live image.
Make you feel that way. I could be the one to set you free. Do you think about me when the crowd is gone? It used to be so easy, you and me. I could be the one to make you feel that way. I could be the one to set you free.
All right. Thank you, guys. Like I said, as many photos as you want, anytime. Okay, so let's bring in the glamour shots here. Dark gray, matte black, and gold. These models are really very, very good looking, aren't they? Manu, I think you just got yourself a plan B, just in case. Our very own Sudeep Sahu. Sudeep is awesome. Our queen, Sri Das, which I think deserves special applause. Yeah? Chief Commander Galsasi Bro. And last but not least, Mr. GQ here, Jay Sir. It's actually pretty annoying how good looking he is in this photo. So, of course, I'm left with no choice but to invite on stage the man himself.
Hey, everyone. All right, so I get to talk about my favorite thing, battery life. Redmi Note 3 was the first Mi phone we shipped with a battery over 4,000 mAh. Now, it seemed crazy at the time, but an awesome combination of a high-density battery with really strong engineering and design was totally unbeatable. We received glowing reviews from the media and every corner of the country, and especially from the Mi fans. People started calling Redmi Note 3 the king of battery. Of course, These reviews came out as we were starting to design Redmi Note 4 last year. So we asked ourselves, is it possible to double down on battery life and go even further? Can we do even better? It should be easy. Just make the battery bigger and bigger, right? Well, we're using the same high-density battery technology, so the battery is about the same capacity as Redmi Note 3. Now, if we're not increasing the battery size, how can we make better battery life? This is one of the major design challenges for Redmi Note 4. Increase the battery by 20% without making the battery bigger. So how do we do this? Well, the answer to this question rests on 14-nanometer FinFET technology. This was a breakthrough in chip design that made processors much more power efficient. I'll explain more about this in a little bit. Qualcomm introduced FinFET technology into their product line with Snapdragon 820. It allowed them to pack a lot more transistors into a chip and increase power efficiency at the same time. It's basically Moore's Law in full swing. The FinFET architecture is one of the key technological investments that made it possible to do mobile VR, for example. Qualcomm launched Snapdragon 820 in 2015. It was their first 14-nanometer FinFET processor. In 2016, they launched Snapdragon 821, also 14-nanometer, which powers Mix, for example. But the biggest breakthrough in Qualcomm's 2016 chip lineup was bringing 14-nanometer FinFET to the 600 series, Snapdragon 625, to be specific. This was the answer to our battery life challenge. Redmi Note 4 is powered by Snapdragon 625. It's Qualcomm's first 600 series processor built on 14-nanometer FinFET technology. And this is the global debut of Redmi Note 4 powered by Snapdragon 625. That's right, it's coming to India first before any other markets, including China. Thank you. I was hoping that would get an applause, so thank you. Now, as I promised, I was going to explain this 14-nanometer thing a little bit more, so let's do that. There are billions of transistors inside a microchip, and these are basically the ones and zeros that power your smartphone. So you can think of each transistor as a light switch. When it's switched off, it represents a zero. And when you apply enough voltage, it flips on, and it represents a one. Well, the 14-nanometer transistors in Redmi Note 4 are about half the size of the 28-nanometer transistors in Redmi Note 3. Smaller transistors require less voltage to flip the switch. And because there are billions of transistors inside a microchip, this can add up to pretty big power savings. But these transistors are not just smaller. They're also more robust. This is because they use FinFET technology. This minimizes power leakage at the transistor level. So let me explain. What you see here is a typical transistor. Current flows through this yellow part, the two-dimensional channel. So 28 nanometer actually refers to the length of this channel. The yellow part that sits on top of the channel is the gate, this part here. This is what controls the transistor switching on and off for your ones and zeros. Now, when a transistor is switched off, no current is supposed to flow through this channel. But there actually is some current leakage, especially as transistors get smaller. So here on the right is a FinFET transistor. It has a 3D channel, kind of like a fin, protruding from the surface. This is why they call it FinFET. But the important thing in FinFET is that the gate actually wraps around the channel on all three sides. Because of this, the gate has significantly more control over the current flow in the channel, so it reduces current leakage. This actually saves a lot of power, and it's what gives Redmi Note 4 a huge edge over Redmi Note 3. And the results are astounding. So in our lab tests, Redmi Note 4 scored higher than Redmi Note 3 across the board in battery consumption. If you look at some of the numbers here, we have 60% longer music playback, 55% longer video playback, and my favorite, 46% longer 3G talk time. In our average tests, Redmi Note 4 battery lasts 25% longer than Redmi Note 3. So we definitely hit our goal with some room to spare. Of course, these are lab tests. So we asked our Mi Explorers to run tests in real life, and the results are impressive. So Furquan here got 7.5 hours of screen on time with really heavy video usage. He said he watched, I think, 2 movies and 5 TV shows. Dilip got over 10 hours of screen on time. But this one is the craziest one. Sangat got a full day, literally 24 hours of screen on time. Actually, over 24 hours of screen on time. This number totally shocked me when I saw it. It's pretty insane. I'm not even sure how it's possible. But I guess the data doesn't lie. So we have pretty creative ways of testing battery in our own office, and we also have the best mascot. You guys might remember Ollie from our previous launch events. Well, she's back in action in this new endurance video. Let's take a look.
Okay, Ollie, I'm gonna put you in Hugo's room for a day. You're a good girl, okay?
So Ollie is adorable, and that's actually Hugo's office she messed up. So of course, it's an awesome video. That aside, Redmi Note 4 lasted about 70% longer than both the Pixel XL and the iPhone 7 Plus on this battery endurance video. So we shot another comparison video to see what you can do with just 5% battery on Redmi Note 4. And we got our in-house rock stars, Anisha, Sudeep, and Gelsasi, to help out with this video. It's pretty fun. Let's take a look at this one.
The car kickoff challenge.
Google Pixel.
iPhone 7 Plus.
And I have the Redmi Note 4. Let's do this. I'm pretty sure I'll beat both of you guys here.
I'll just let the phone load the top.
Why do you take
how long
video and portrait? Who is going to watch that, Anisha?
Okay, fine. All right. I go. Oh!
It's gone?
It's shut down. My phone
yes.
shut down.
That means we are going to kick out Anisha.
No!
By the side.
We'll see you in the office.
Go.
See you. Bye.
Bye, Anisha.
Bye, Anisha. We should navigate back to office. I'm going to start. Who do you think is going to win?
I'm going to win. I will give you a haircut.
Why would I want that? If I win, you're gonna pay for the next haircut at Onion Guy. And if you win, I would pay for your next haircut.
Whoa.
You're gonna watch.
Whoa.
Wow.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Whoa. Oh, it's died. Oh, my phone died.
Whoa!
Like my phone died.
Yes! I told you guys, Redmi Note 4, the king of battery.
I have won the car kickoff challenge. So Rohit, do you remember our bet? You're gonna pay for my Tony and Guy haircut.
So I don't know why they're obsessed with haircuts, and of all things, two dudes can have a bet on. I don't know why it's a haircut. But as Sudeep said it himself, Redmi Note 4 is definitely the new king of battery. And I totally agree with it. So another critical improvement from the 14-nanometer FinFET technology is thermal performance. Redmi Note 3 was famously known for its stellar thermal performance, and many of you guys said this yourselves. Because of 14-nanometer FinFET technology, Redmi Note 4 takes this thermal performance to a whole new level. So we ran a 30-minute intensive 3D gaming test using Asphalt Nitro, comparing Redmi Note 4 and Redmi Note 3. We actually had to make the test very long to get to the point where Redmi Note 3 even starts to heat up. So let's take a look at the results. Here we have Redmi Note 3 on the left and Redmi Note 4 on the right. You can see that they start pretty much at the same base temperature. At around 5 minutes in, both still pretty much the same. Around 10 minutes, not much of a difference. It took us 30 minutes to get Redmi Note to cross 40 degrees Celsius in a visible way. But if you take a look at the right here, Redmi Note 4 doesn't even get warm. The vast majority of this device is still under a cool 37, 38 degrees. That's basically it. I mean, Redmi Note 4 has awesome thermal performance, so you can keep cool and carry on. So let's do a quick rundown. First of all, Redmi Note 4 has the same great Snapdragon performance that our hardcore users expect from things like the Adreno 506 GPU and the Qualcomm X9 LTE modem. Number two, we built a phone with 25% more battery life without increasing the battery size at all. I guess technically we increased it by 1%, but. Number three, it has absolutely best-in-class thermal performance. Redmi Note 4 has the best sustained gaming performance of any device we've ever seen. And I know you guys are gonna love it. So with that, let's kick it back to Hugo.
All right. Thanks, Jay. Well, I'm gonna reiterate these points here. When it comes to performance, Redmi Note 4 is spectacular. Number one, sustained gaming performance, just throw any game you want at it. Number two, the absolute new king of battery life, to quote Sudeep. And number three, thermal performance like you've never seen before. And definitely don't just take my word for it. Ask any of our Mi Explorers here. There's 50 of you. They've been trying to push Redmi Note 4 to its limits for the past couple of months. Right, guys? All right. Speaking of which, from all of the user feedback that we got on Redmi Note 3 over many months, the biggest area of improvement was most definitely camera. We invested a ton of time into not only sourcing the right great hardware, but also optimizing it a lot. The sensor we're using on Redmi Note 4 is a 13-megapixel CMOS sensor, which we sourced from Sony and Samsung. It's backside illuminated, and it uses phase detection autofocus. Most importantly, 25% larger pixel area compared to the Redmi Note 3 sensor, and this really shows. This is a shot taken on Redmi Note 3, which does admittedly struggle a bit in an exposure-challenged scene like this one. And there's the same shot on Redmi Note 4. I'm gonna do this again. Redmi Note 3, Redmi Note 4. It kind of tells the entire story here. Much more balanced and better exposed photo, crisper by a wide margin, and to really see this, check out the detail around the water here, right? You can see a clear difference. By the way, this is not an HDR shot, right? This is just a straight-up shot. So significant and noticeable camera upgrade. Now, to really push Redmi Note 4 and its camera to the test, we asked a couple of professional photographers to do a photo travel diary for us traveling around India. Our photographers traveled all the way to Bhuj. This is the giant salt desert, the Great Run of Kutch. Look at the detail on the clothes here, for example, despite the fact that this photo is taken against the sun. How majestic is the Wind Palace in Jaipur? Beautiful, right? Rebbe Note 4 really does capture intricate details and furnishings here. Again, even indoors, taking a photo against a sunny window. This is City Palace in Jaipur. The detail you get on Rebbe Note 4 is simply amazing. I love this shot. Beautiful close-up. This one was taken in Varanasi. I love how vibrant the colors here are. You can even see the details on the different strands of hair on this gentleman's beard here. It's a very lively shot. Sunrises and sunsets are beautiful as well. Here's another sunset photo from another perspective. It really captures the beautiful alleys of Varanasi. I love this shot. Gorgeous reflection of the boat here in the water in Alleppey in Kerala. This photo is really, really crisp. By the way, you can see all the EXIF data on the bottom here if you're interested. The built-in black and white filter delivers really gorgeous contrast, great for portraiture. Another captivating black and white image here taken with Redmi Note 4. This Brahmini kite is absolutely my favorite. Just check out the detail level. You almost can't believe someone was able to take this photo. You can really see everything here. This is a very, very dramatic photo. Again, EXIF details on the bottom there. This is pretty cool. We even attached Redmi Note 4 to a drone at Alleppey Beach in Kerala, and we got this stunning sunset aerial shot flying Redmi Note 4. Here's another beautiful aerial photo of a resort overlooking the lake here. We were careful enough not to go too close to the swimming pools. And of course, we also enlisted our fearless Mi explorers to share their photos taken with Redmi Note 4. I wish I had time to share all of them here. There's a lot of really amazing photography. This one is taken at the Grand Canyon in the United States. Beautiful light play on this colonial house. This one is taken by Shramona. This is a photo of her cat. Beautiful, right? This delicious croissant here making me feel hungry. This is taken by Shivesh. Another one, this is taken by Vijay Raj, who some of you may know, of course. Love the colors on this photo. Just really beautiful colors. Good framing, too. This is a macro shot taken by Bingo220. He even managed to capture the detail here of the steam from the cooked peanuts. Gorgeous shot. Another macro shot by Harsh. Harsh took this one with the help of macro lenses, special macro lenses. Our explorers, of course, really go to the limits here of photography, and this shot looks fantastic. Many, many more of these for you guys to take a look at. They'll be available on Facebook. 5-megapixel front camera, and really important note here, we've completely revamped Beautify, which is one of the signature features of MIUI. Now it has two modes, Smart and Pro, gives you a lot more control over your beautification. Check it out. Redmi Note 4's full HD display is very carefully color calibrated. We pay a lot of attention here. It features reading mode, which is very popular in MIUI now, which really helps reduce eye strain. I personally use it all the time. Now, many of you already know this, practically all Mi phones have capacitive keys, since our goal is to maximize use of the display for content. Now, I thought I'd mention this because we continue to see many, many devices, phones launching with soft keys and a big chin. I personally don't get it. I think it completely defeats the purpose. Our focus is on building phones with the best possible displays. So we've continued going down the path of capacitive touch keys. And of course, a fingerprint sensor on the back. This was a signature from Redmi Note 3. And it doubles, again, also signature from Redmi Note 3 as a selfie shutter. Makes it easier for you to take your selfies. Every Mi phone, as you know, ships with an IR sensor. And the Mi Remote app supports hundreds of home appliance models here in India. Redmi Note 4 ships, as you'd expect, with LTE band support, of course, VoLTE out of the box, and it includes band 5, which is basically essential for you to be able to take indoor VoLTE calls. Dual SIM with a 3-choose-2 SIM tray, which allows you to use an SD card, one SD, one SIM, or two SIMs. Redmi Note 4 supports up to 128 gigs of storage. It ships with MIUI 8, and here's a special surprise, MIUI Explorers. We're already running a special preview of Android N 7.0, so Mi fans who get their hands on Redmi Note 4 in the first sale can already flash to Android N. And we'll push Android N to stable once we get enough strong feedback from our beta user community. So definitely check it out. Of course, Redmi Note 4 is also made in India. No big news here. So I want to sum it all up. Redmi Note 4 is really an incredible work from our team. Premium metal body with 2.5D glass for the first time on a Redmi device. Snapdragon 625 based on 14 nanometer FinFET technology. You know more about transistors today than you probably thought you would. 25% longer battery life compared to Redmi Note 3, which is really an amazing achievement. Redmi Note 3 was the former king of battery. Outstanding thermal performance, which is really important here in India. Big camera upgrade, and we've basically made zero compromises. Picture abhi baki hai mere dost. Our first Redmi phone to ship with 4 gigs of RAM and 64 gigs of flash, and as far as I can tell, it's a first in this category too. What do you guys think? It's time. Okay. You know, what I usually do when I get here is, of course, compare with other brands, other premium products in the market. But today I thought, let's just focus on one thing here. We're raising the bar for ourselves. We're figuring out how to deliver even more innovation for the money to our fans. So what I have here is Redmi Note 3 and Redmi Note 4. I don't even have to say again how big of an upgrade Redmi Note 4 is to Redmi Note 3. We've gone from 28 nanometer technology to 14 nanometer FinFET technology. We increased RAM to 4 gigabytes. We have an incredible processor in Snapdragon 625. We've doubled the maximum flash to 64 gigs. We've slightly increased the battery size, but we've added 25% more battery life. We've gone from max 32 to max 128 of expandable storage, and we have a huge camera upgrade, as you've seen from some of the shots that I shared with you here today. Redmi Note 3 started at $9999, while Redmi Note 4 will start at $9999. This is for the version with 2 gigs of RAM and 16 gigs of storage. The 4 gig, 64 gig version will go for $12999. That's 4 gigs, 64 gigs. And then we have a 332 version as well at $10999. What do you guys think? Awesome, right? There you go. So, Redmi Note 4, power has a new look, incredible product, 25% greater battery life, beautifully designed, incredibly symmetrical, unprecedented thermal performance. Do you guys want to take another photo? Okay. Can I have 2 devices, please? Celine, we're going to do another photo here. All right. Here we go. Yeah. very well. So that's what we had for you guys today. And we have lots of photos. We have our experience center outside for you to check out Redmi Note 4 for yourself. Definitely check out the new black matte color, which is absolutely beautiful. Now, for Mi fans who want to check it out in person around India, I'm really excited to announce that we will be arranging for 4 Mi Home pop-ups in Mumbai, Hyderabad, Chennai, and Bangalore over the next month so that you can experience Redmi Note 4 in person as well as many other exciting Mi products from our portfolio. This is it. Thank you guys very much and see you outside.